Hello students, welcome to the class of Editorial Decode, and in this class I will be decoding the Iran deal, a triumph for diplomacy, written by Stanley Johnny. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is very, very important for political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how the antagonistic relationship between Iran and United States of America is transforming. This editorial is also about how the rapprochement between these two antagonistic nations will lead to a new fodder for the global diplomacy. This editorial is also about how diplomacy, how consultations, how talks and how negotiations can prove to be really effective even in case of two disparate countries. Now, in order to properly understand this editorial, we need to know about the Iranian Revolution. And before we know about the Iranian Revolution, it is important to know about what is a revolution. Now, revolution is a phenomena that will introduce a change that will be there to stay, a change that will be permanent, a change that will transform many things, a change that will not be a transient one. Now, in order to get more effectiveness about the meaning of this revolution, we should also compare it with a revolt. Now, revolt is nothing but a desire, an action for a certain desire that certainly proves to be unsuccessful. And revolution is something that will be a successful phenomena, like the case of French Revolution, Russian Revolution, American Revolution, Chinese Revolution, etc., etc. Now, what is Iranian Revolution? Revolution is about a change. So we must know about what kind of change was introduced by this Iranian Revolution. A change that had resulted in antagonizing its European partners and United States of America. Aisa kya Iranian Revolution ne kar diya ki United States of America Iran ke saath khafa ho gaya. Now, what is Iranian Revolution? Iranian Revolution ka agar hum nature dekhe, it was basically a Shia politico-economy change. Now, what kind of a change was it? In order to understand the change, we need to understand about the history of Iran. Now, from 1900 onwards till 1979, when the revolution actually took place, Iran was ruled by three dynasties: the Safavid dynasty, the Qajar dynasty, and the Pahlavi dynasty. Now, out of these three dynasties, two dynasties, specifically the Qajar dynasty and the Pahlavi dynasty, they had remained under the suzerainty, they had remained under the influence, they had remained under the guidance, they had remained under the action, they had remained under the direction of the Western forces. When I am telling you about the Western forces, it actually means that the Pahlavi dynasty and the Qajar dynasty, they were guided by the spirit of capitalism. They were less inclined towards the teachings of Islam, teachings of the Shias. Now, of the two kings that we had in this Pahlavi dynasty, it was the Reza Muhammad Shah which was more inclined towards the United States of America. Now, from about 1950 onwards, around 1968, it was the Reza Muhammad Shah that he has helped Iran to get out of the economic crisis. Now, how he has helped Iran to get out of the economic crisis. It was primarily because of the oil resource. So the oil resource in the Iran has helped it to get out of this crisis. So despite Iran was doing well on the economic front, still there was existence of poverty, still there was prevalence of a lot of unemployment. And this unemployment and poverty, these are the two cardinal things, these are the two cardinal aspects which generally produces a lot of disenchantment, dissatisfaction among the people. And these two things have actually been the cause behind the French Revolution, American Revolution, Russian Revolution. And these two were the causes behind the Iranian revolutions. And these two causes, coupled with the desire of the clergy, clergy wanted to institutionalize, clergy wanted to entrench, clergy wanted to stabilize, clergy wanted to create an Islamic setup in Iran. Now, why it wanted to set up that? As I have told you, the kings of the Pahlavi dynasty, they were more oriented towards West. So, under their functioning, they were actually allowing a lot of liberty to the women. They were allowing a lot of fundamentals, rights to the people. And this is something that was abhorred. This is something that was hatred. This is something that was disliked by the clergy. The clergy wanted to establish a Puritan form of Islamic culture. And in order to make their presence felt in the mind of the people, they also took the support of the poor performance of the economy. Ayatollah Khomeini is the spiritual leader of Iran, and by institutionalizing this 1979 revolution, Iranian revolution, he has nationalized the entire oil industry. Now the entire oil industry is not in the hand of the capitalist, it is actually in the hands of the Iranian government. Now this was something that was disliked by the United States of America and by the European nations, because they wanted to imperialize the oil resources, they wanted to capitalize on the oil resources, and this was something that was not allowed by the Ayatollah Khomeini. Now there has been a change in the dispensation, the ante that was upped by the Ayatollah Khomeini, he has moderated that, he has mitigated his ante. Now he wanted to reproach with the United States of America. And the United States of America has also become conciliatory, is also ready for the rapprochement. Now why it is ready for the rapprochement? It is ready for the rapprochement because it wanted to create a kind of a soft image. For about 60 years, America had been an embodiment of an aggressor, an embodiment of that is trampling on the liberties of the countries, on the sovereignties of the countries. Now it wants to bring about a change. Now it also wants to balance out the equation between Shias and Sunnis. It wanted to put forward a more magnanimous face, a face that is more acceptable to the Muslim world. It don't want to antagonize the Muslim world. Now it wanted to focus more on the economic aspect, and because of that it has accepted to reconcile the issues with Iran. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is IAS Mentors and EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594000 in case you are interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And to avail the information about the classes that we are offering, please visit our website eiasmentors.com and brainkey.com. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is BrainyKey. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.